According to the ASPCA, the American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, on their article titled "A Closer Look at Puppy Mills," last updated in 2018, estimated that there are over 10,000 illegal dog breeders in America. Each of us in this room either have a dog or know somebody in this room who has a dog. But do we ever stop to think how that dog got here? The cruelty within puppy mills has an effect on the dogs, the puppies, and the owners. Today, I will first be informing you about the problems puppy mills cause, and secondly, on the solution to that problem. To begin, let's discuss the problem of puppy mills. According to McLellan, a veterinary author, published in the Journal of Veterinary Behavior on May 1st, 2017, his researchers found that the conditions that the dog lived in puppy mills are horrendous. They are usually kept in wire cages their entire lives, never get to see a vet, and the cage is only a foot bigger than the animal itself. The female dogs are bred one after the other, not getting any time to recover. They often have many diseases and never get the proper treatment or care, which leads to more illness and disease. If the dogs somehow make it out of the puppy mills, which often they do not, they're left with life-threatening illnesses, such as epilepsy, heart failure, respiratory problems, and behavioral issues. According to McLellan, as cited previously, puppies also get to their owners with health problems. In many states, there are no regulations to fix this problem. Puppy mills go to the pet store from the puppy mills and then to the owners. But all that time, they can be sick. And there is no way to protect the consumer buying the puppy from that illness or to let them know. Puppies can also develop genetic disorders, as well as Giardia, heartworm, parasites, and other infections. They develop their genetic problems due to the non-stop breeding of their mothers. According to McLellan, in another journal titled Applied Animal Behavior Sciences in 2011, found that because of the health issues between the dogs and the puppies, the owners of them spend more and more time and money at the vet. Because of the variation of all of the illnesses that they have, it can either mean a few visits to the vet or a lifetime of them. According to McLellan, in another journal titled The Journal of the American Veterinary Medical Association in 2013, estimated that a new puppy can cost anywhere from $200 to $5,000. But this doesn't include the price of the 3 rounds of shots the puppies require, also any medication that they might need due to all their illnesses or behavioral problems. This also doesn't include any of the surgeries they would need, which can be a very unexpected surprise to any new coming pet owner. Now that I've told you about the problems that puppy mills cause, I will tell you about the solution. According to Virginia Law Library, developed by the Division of Legislative Automated Systems, last updated in 2018, found that the best solution to this problem is to regulate commercial dog breeders heavily. That way it protects the consumers buying the puppy and the dogs that live there. Virginia is rated top in the country for this. They are able to regulate the puppy mills, give the dogs veterinary care, and have a very good history on the dog, and still protect the consumer. It is a felony offense to abuse an animal in most states. But if we make this nationwide and not just in most states, it will also prevent illegal breeders from continuing their actions. But what it doesn't prevent is that it doesn't make it easier to find the illegal dog breeders. And it doesn't prevent them from selling their puppies online. To review, today I've told you about the ways the puppies cause problems, the puppy mills cause problems, and secondly, the solution to the problem. Remember when I told you that the ASPCA estimated that there are over 10,000 illegal puppy mills in America? One of my dogs came from one of those puppy mills, and we didn't know. When we got him, he had Giardia, inverted eyelashes, and an inverted tail. It took months of medication and surgeries to fix what they had done to him. The cruelty within puppy mills affects the puppies, the dogs, and the owners. We need to end the suffering that these animals are going through. So next time you see a dog, you'll know where it came from.